This is Walk with Travel and Leisure. I'm Sameli, and this is our Aegiali walking tour on the Greek island of Amorgos. Today we will be walking in the area of Aegiali, which is the northern part of the island of Amorgos. We will be visiting an old olive press, a distillery of essential oils from local herbs, a Greek Orthodox church, while we will be enjoying amazing views from the surrounding mountains towards the sea and people in their everyday life. So we have reached our first village of the tour, Lagada. The villages are traditionally built up in the mountains. That's why you see all the steps. They're uphill. It created a sort of a buffer zone between the sea and their houses, because in the past, invasions were a very, very, very serious issue. So the other element that we see is that they are tightly built, houses one next to the other, creating very small corridors to protect from the wind and mainly from the invaders, as this wouldn't allow great numbers of invaders coming in. So here we are inside the Greek Orthodox Church. This is the parish church of the village of Tholaria. What we can see actually is one quite rare example, because it's quite big for an island church. We have a few more on the island. What's also interesting here is that it's been very recently renovated. What's also interesting in this church is that right below we have a treasury with some important manuscripts, old books, which can be visited and very much appreciated. So here we have reached the edge of the village of Tholaria, and what we can see over there is the hill of what is called Archaea Vigla, meaning ancient Vigla, which is actually the site of the ancient city-state of Aegiali. And we can see some beautiful old rural buildings here, stables, storage houses. All this just marks the eternal presence of human here in the island. So we are approaching now our first deviation for the day, one of these amazing old doors. So we are visiting an old olive press here at the village of Lagada, owned by Mr. Dimitris Nomikos. Kalimera, kiri Dimitri. So this is a real old olive press, and this is actually the stone mill. People would bring here their olives and they would set their olives here, and a mule tied here would go around moving the cylinders. This is in fact the older olive press. You see it's much different, it's just a single cylinder here, and it works with the force of men, with the power of men. In fact, it works with the power of a girl and a boy. And Dimitris now will come here to show us how it used to be done. Kire Dimitri, καθόμαστε πίσω. Πάμε. Oh, that's a lot of labor. So the idea is that the girl goes in the front and the boy behind chases her. So this is the press itself, where the paste would be stacked in this kind of cloth envelopes, stacked all together, pressed with the wooden stick there, that people would turn around, squeezing and producing the olive oil. Much work. Here we are at Panagia Epanochoriani, which means the Virgin Mary of the upper side of the village. It's actually a church that is important in two main dates. First, during Carnival. Carnival Sunday, this is the location where the men of Lagada village gather and choose their captain, capitanos. The other great date here is the 15th of August, the celebration of Virgin Mary. We do have a banquet, a festive banquet, when food is offered to all pilgrims, and these are the tables that are used. Watch out for your heads. So this is Agia Triada, the Holy Trinity. It's a chapel, but essentially it played the role of a castle for Lagada village. It's where residents would find refuge in times of danger when they would see pirates or invaders coming from the sea. It looks pretty tiny nowadays, but believe it or not, it would indeed fit the whole population of Lagada. This is the next gorgeous door we're opening. Γεια σου, Βαγγέλη. Α, γεια σου, Μυρτώ. Τι κάνετε? So, we are at a distillery of essential oils made from local herbs. That's pretty exciting, I would say. So, here, our friends Μυρτώ and Βαγγέλης are loading oregano. They're about to process oregano to make the essential oil of the plant. So, as you can see, there it goes. There's a lot of oregano in there. Inside it goes. Ready to start the boiling process. And what happens is the steam comes up. It goes through what is called the condenser, obviously to be condensed, essentially to be liquefied back again. And the end product is this double liquid, water and essential oil. So we have actually removed the water part. And now here comes the essential oil. I can tell you it smells pretty awesome in here. That's the best part of every visit.
Okay, we're drinking, here we're drinking happy raki.
Happy raki, love it. Cheers.
It's raki infused with hypericum, which is the happy
Ooh.
Plant.
Γεια σας. That was great. So here we are. That's almost the end of our walk, reaching the beach of Aegiali. Once again, on those amazing cobblestone paths, approaching the bay of Aegiali with the villages of the port of Aegiali and Potamos above it. Thank you for walking with us today. I hope you really enjoyed our walk and that I see you soon here in Amorgos with Emily, finding Greece and the Blue Walk.